Greg Kot with Chicago Tribune here. Just got back from the Justin Timberlake Jay-Z concert at Soldier Field. Over 60,000 people there. It looked like a very full house. There may have been a few tickets left, but it was pretty packed in there. It was an epic show. There was no opening act. You're talking about two of the key performers in pop music today, two of the dominant performers playing 35, 36 of their best known songs. That's a pretty good enticement to come out on a Monday night and stay till almost midnight, as most of the crowd did. I mean, hardly anybody left early for this show. They stuck it out to the very end. And I think what you were seeing here is kind of the yin and yang of R&B and hip hop. Justin does a lot more work on stage in terms of he's jumping around between instruments, playing keyboards, playing guitar, sideman for Jay-Z. He's not a great dancer. He's not a great singer. He's not a particularly great musician. But you put it all together, he's got something. He's got charisma. He's an entertainer. He's a song and dance man. He's a classic song and dance man. Jay-Z barely moves at all on stage. He moves stealthily. It's almost like he's a cat, a big cat sneaking up on its prey. You almost get that sort of sense with him. It's very stealthy, very smooth, very little movement, and yet incredible command. The way he uses his voice, the way he used the microphone with the voice, you know, staccato cadences followed by more robust statesman-like statements. The material from the last three or four albums hasn't been that strong, but you realize the man's got close to two decades worth of hits, and when he goes back to the well for those classic songs, whether it's 99 Problems or Hard Knock Life, those songs really resonate with a couple of generations of listeners. I thought there was a notable moment in the show where Timberlake started singing the track New York, New York, the song associated with Sinatra, New York, New York. And of course, you can imagine how that went over in Chicago. People were, you could see people starting to rustle a little bit and a few people booing. And Timberlake, after a verse or so, a couple of lines actually, stops the song and says, "Chicago, you know I love you, right?" And it was just, that's his personality. He doesn't want to be confrontational at all. He wants to be loved by all. He's a very ingratiating, charismatic performer. But, there's no real rough edges to what Justin Timberlake's doing. Whereas Jay-Z follows up with Empire State of Mind, again, another huge New York City anthem. And he's like, he's owning it. He's not apologizing for it. In fact, as the chorus comes up, you hear the Alicia Keys hook. That was one of the few canned moments of the show, actually. He's saying, "Sing it to me," to the audience. He's just saying, "Sing it to me, because I'm the king of New York, and you need to acknowledge that." The difference in attitude was kind of telling. Jay-Z was definitely the senior member on stage. He was the kingpin. Justin Timberlake almost seemed like the eager apprentice, eager to please. But I think you put the two together, and they complemented each other very well. Maybe Jay-Z's a little too hard-hitting. Maybe Justin is too puppy dog soft. You put them together, and you've got really a nice blend there, and that's really what the show was all about.